we are relying on a ground and aerial vehicle combo. And what we've been bringing to the table in this is visual inertial simultaneous localization and mapping. We've been bringing some object detection, what they call artifact detection in the challenge, that is all custom, as well as actual platforms that in some part are custom. The whole goal of the challenge is actually to identify where artifacts are or where these objects are within these different subterranean environments. Cell phones, survivors, for power tools, for fire extinguishers, where's the red backpack, things like this. And we're sending all that information back to DARPA so that they can actually judge us, score us based on how many of these we've found, how accurate our positioning is on these artifacts, and how quickly we found them, because in terms of first responders and search and rescue types of missions, which is what this is really trying to focus on, then the time is of the essence. And so this brings about some real difficult problems for robotic platforms. First of all, long deployments. This is 30 minutes to an hour of complete autonomy. It's radio darkness, so there's absolutely no way we can teleoperate these robots in this place. This is a really challenging perception environment because you have no light in there, and so there's also problems with that. There's a lot of redundancy or patterns that come up in the walls that you're trying to follow, so it's very hard to say where you've been. Anyone who's ever done caving before knows this is like very difficult. And finally, just being able to be mobile in these kinds of environments, it's very narrow, closed in. We can run into anything, and that might mean utter failure and catastrophe, right, for our robotic team.